One thing we've not talked about much, yet it was one of our biggest jobs, was we had to repair our 9-meter carbon fiber boom.
When we come inside to the basin for a tip over the boat, we have one problem on board. We break the boom.
It's very skinny, the material. Now we know.
We believe to manage to do one big job, very good, strong.
It's the ghost of the boom.
For those of you that are new to our channel, we're refitting an Open 60, originally designed and raced in the Bondi Globe. We've spent the last 2 years on the hardstand in Fiji, transforming her into a family cruiser, and are now finally back in the water. But before we start with the sailing videos, we've still got some of the jobs from the last few months to share with you.
Okay, hi from Sailing Yacht NV, I'm Timo. I'm here to start the project to rebuild the boom. Maybe a lot of you don't know, but when we come inside to the basin for a tip over the boat.
Our 4.2 meter draft meant that to enter the marina to haul out, we had to heel the boat over to reduce our draft as the channel was too shallow for us.
We used the boom with one heavy dinghy full of water, chain and other weight inside. That is not the problem, but it happened. The friend maneuvered the top up of the boom, the pull up, the halyard for pulling up the boom. Don't saw the vangis arrive to the limit and force the boom up to when it break. Me and Joanna, at the time we are on the water to fix the balloon below the hole, and we don't saw and it happened. This boom break at the time in regatta is ready repair. We believe to manage to do one big job, very good, strong.
What's this boom? There is an old video, old picture to the around the world, the three Sydney Oba. And me, I have to cut in two, take the mold from the inside, what we have to build one pipe sleeve.
We have to build one sleeve in carbon fiber vacuum to glue inside to the boom, rejoin the boom. I'm making the sleeve for re-glue all together and re-laminate on the top.
Our plan for this job is to make a mold of the shape in order to make a sleeve that will fit inside to glue both parts to.
This is only the system for keep all together in form, glue straight. Yeah. After I start to laminate the boom.
So we're marking it so that we know, we make sure we join it together again in the right position. Very hot for wearing this stuff, huh? Sweaty Timo, sweaty, sweaty.
Cut in two.
It's very skinny, the material. Now we know. Watch the string for reinforce all along. And for do this job, we start to cut out ring of two boom on the stern of the boom and on the bow of the boom, up to when we reach the pure carbon with no delamination. And the reason why I cut 3 times 25 mil, and I reach the pure carbon with no delamination. Second ring, we find again the lamination, and after we arrive to the last ring, where in the side to the delamination you still see the delamination. Dopo this side I go to show you in the boom, there is no more delamination. And this is the stern, and this is the bow, one ring, delamination. And second ring, big ring, and no more delamination in both sides. This is the side where we go to rejoin. And then the important is this, the last two. This ring, we got to use it for built a sleeve. And this ring, we got to use it for a model, the mold for built the sleeve. I got to show you also the cut on the boom. And now the boom look like absolutely better because there is no more delamination, like you see.
The material this boom was made out of is very heavy with large gaps between the threads. It looks to have been made by wet manual lamination. Nowadays, there are more modern techniques involving pre-preg or infused materials laminated in a vacuum or an oven.
And the second part, so the stern, is very clean. This is do it like this. This boom is very strange. It's not the lamination, it's the system they use it for built. It's like one frame inside, roughly built, after the laminate on the top. Okay, sad, I don't have the good material. I have only cardboard, making a little bit too much fold. Okay, step of preparation of the mold. I don't have one good material. I prefer something like a PVC plastic skinny, bend and roll better, but at the moment I have only this cardboard. I try to use it for reconstruction, one cylinder, exactly same of the boom, but with one diameter more low, because I put a special in wood, 1 centimeter each, for reconstruction the same form, but more small. It's quite straight, but I don't manage to have the perfect form. I have to cut the correct quantity. It's not easy to calculate how much, and try to bend more the last two corner for don't build so pointy. Now I try to pull out, bend a little bit, and re-put in back. Ciao. Nice cut. Ciao! It's not bad. Not bad. Sunset, Iervo da Marina.
Now that we've made the mold, we use this to laminate a carbon fiber sleeve in a vacuum. First, we cover this cardboard mold with plastic and peel ply to stop the epoxy from sticking to it.
Na 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 na.
Next, it was time to prepare the vacuum bag. We prepare the vacuum bag with a layer of butyl tape around the outside. This is then used to seal the bag and create the vacuum. We prepared a vacuum bag that was twice the length of the sleeve so that we could slide half of it inside the cylinder and have half of it on the outside to create the vacuum exactly around the cylinder edge.
The bagging is ready. I have to slide in after the glue inside and outside. But all tape is ready, and this one is with the PPI ready, with the plastic below, don't go to glue to the cardboard. Now we need the correct quantity of PPI, the correct quantity of micro-hole plastic, the correct quantity size of mosquito net, the correct size of carbon, we prepare all, and we fiberglass, and we have vacuum. Okay, I cut the carbon, the minus 45 plus 45, that'd be axial. The correct size is 70, like the profile I prepared for the boom. It's long 1 meter 30. I go to do one big roll, and I think it's all good. B axial, peel ply, micro hole plastic, mosquito net, the hose, our pump, the cable for the power, the profile with the peel ply is ready, the bags is ready, I have to slide in and close outside, butylic tape, we have some ready, it's not too much, and now table for work. Thank you. Vai giù. E giù nel vacuum.
Oh. Not guaranteed. You have to check because if there is no sun leak, the pump don't stop. But it's good. Nice to meet you.
It's very nice. It's very vacuum. Very nice. Maybe the pump don't manage to stop. I have to keep on, but it's good. Okay, now the vacuum is messy. It's very high. It start to be very, very tight. I think now the pump go to stop. We are minus one. Watch. Bah! No way! Woo! Vabbè, it's okay. It's okay. Woo! It work. Wow! Because you see, the thing is, now the bagging is doing from inside outside. Quindi the bag push to compress on the mold. And really I got to think, I got to manage to have one very nice form. Very tight. It's very good. The vacuum still super tight. Watch. Super tight. Very good job. It's very tight. Very happy. And now stay in the vacuum.
GG.
That is a fucking is the ghost of the boom. Quindi it's very important. Let me do two roll and a half, probably a little bit more, about minus 45 and plus 45, the B axle. 45 like this. That's a minute ready. There is the ghost, the interior one is ready, bam, there. After I go with the unidirectional.
Yeah.
I do plenty unidirectional and 45. Unidirectional, 45. It's gonna be strong. Unidirectional, 45. I go to do a laminate, 1 centimeter. This is the model. This is one piece of my boom.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is where I cut out from the boom 16. And the 16 is the part I start to laminate directly on the ghost. And after I put it in layer and I go in the top to the boom, bam, 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 bam. Because this is only the system for keep all together in form, glue straight. Yeah. And after I start to laminate the boom. And this quantity of wood is 1 centimeter, is the quantity I want to laminate me. Me, I got to do 1 centimeter inside plus 1 centimeter envelope outside to the boom. Got to be very strong. I got to keep the model because if I fuck up this one, we start again. But I don't think this one look like good. And the system with the peel ply, ready peel ply change, poof, immediately a lot. This only, you see, only peel ply. There is some imperfection, but it's ready, so solid, it's so ready, you can directly painting on the top.
Maybe it's fixing our surface.
Yeah, I can fix it yourself. Yeah, but the excess resin, there is the peel ply absorb the resin. The peel ply is made for absorbing. So coming like this, but don't glue. You see, it's plenty resin.
How does it not stick to it?
There is some wax.
Oh, okay. What do you use to seal the bag?
It's a butylic tape. Oh. It's one tape you use it for the car. I don't know if you never ever open one door to one car. Inside to the furniture to the car is full of this butylic tape. Old one piece of plastic for don't wet when raining.
Like
seals. Yeah, you are mechanic, you know. Yeah, that is the stuff. Uh-huh. Okay, go to glue. Solo! Vieni qua! Vieni qua!
Testa di cazzo!
Mamma mia, che palle! Vieni qua, testa di cazzo! Cosa stai facendo?
No!
Solo io no! No, no, don't worry, the dog! Don't worry, don't worry! No, no!
How are you, manager?
No, solo! Vieni qua! Vieni qua!
Go, go!
Solo! Cazzo! No! Le prendi, eh? No! No!
Very good. Watch my dog. It's better now, eh?
Is it like
now? No, really. It's like me.